Hello again. The fight against illegal mining seems far from over. Some communities in Gauteng have been living in fear because of zamas. Just recently, Riverlea residents in Johannesburg demonstrated against illegal mining. At the same time, zamas have returned to West Village in Krugersdorp, where raids and arrests were made last year in a bid to flush out illegal miners. Let's discuss the impact of the illicit activities on artisanal mining communities. I'm joined now by Meshack Mbangela from the Mining Affected Communities United in Action, or MACUA for short. Meshack, good afternoon. Welcome to today, and thank you very much for your time. Just yesterday here on eNCA, I interviewed the Minister of Mineral Resources and Energy, Gwede Mantashe, and he said government is very clear and determined to help develop artisanal mining in the country and training and equipping and supporting artisanal miners who will be, of course, South Africans. But the challenges there are that your activities in your sector are being affected currently by illegal mining activity. How bad is the situation at present?
Well, but then what happened is that before this became out of hand, we engaged the government in 2013, 2014 regarding the issue of zamas, because those were genuine people who really wanted to be, you know, formalized and in the sector and be able to contribute even to the in the economy of South Africa. But unfortunately, that was turned down, and it was not out of hand as we are facing now. Zamas are people who were genuinely so. And for instance, let me make an example. In Kimberley, they came out and they formed a co-op. And the regional manager, because of that genuine issue, he gave them the permit to be zamas and artisan miners. And unfortunately, we find that in other provinces, that was not done. And from 2014, until now, and we must understand that because of unemployment rate going up, poverty, everyone now understands that there is something to get out there, and everyone, even thugs, are going down there. Even the syndicate are now using these people from outside to start engaging in this sector, which is what's supposed to be have reformed long time ago and engaged. Unfortunately, when we spoke to the TMRE, they said they're not prepared to talk to that. But we wanted to change that and reform that sector to make it quite correct and make sure those people, when you employ people in your company, you know that is who is working there, you understand, and there are people who are monitoring all the situation. But they left it until now, and it's very difficult. What happened to the communities, unfortunately, they will be forced to be affected, because not all the people that are there are zamas. Now we've got illegal people that are there to do dirty work. And that's a fact. But
When we speak about illegal mining, we also use the term zamas. But from what you are saying, are you saying zamas are different from illegal miners?
Definitely so. You see, zamas, what happened is when the mines were still operating and the guys were working in the mine. And when the mine closes down, those guys were the only people who have the only skill of mining, drilling underground. And when the mine closes down, they had nowhere to go. And some of them definitely show, you must understand that is South Africa, Johannesburg is built by the people from outside. Because those people, when mining started, they collected people from Malawi, Zimbabwe, Lesotho to come and work in the mine for slavery or cheap labor and maximize their profits. Based on that, some of the people stayed and, you know, in South Africa did not have working permits and so on. But zamas, when we talked about that, we're talking about people who genuinely and try to engage the MRA to say, look, okay, we are working here, we are doing this work. Let's engage now and formalize this sector.
Okay,
now,
but then you're facing people who are coming to the country illegally from Lesotho, Mozambique, Zimbabwe, as you said, and they are carrying out mining activity without the proper permits or license. Currently, the government wants to regularize or regulate artisanal mining. Would you welcome that as Makua?
Definitely so. That's what we've been asking for from 2013, to engage the zamas, and not just, but make the place that they work in safe and make sure they contribute to them. And we need to engage those people to make sure to understand what is it that they want. Not decide for them, but engage them and see what is it that we can do to make sure it works and it's profitable and it can create employment in this current situation of highly unemployed people facing poverty and inequality.
But the turf wars between the illegal miners amongst themselves and zamas has led to a lot of violence. What is Makua? What have you as Makua been trying to do to make sure that there's no violence?
Well, what we said to the DMRE, because the DMRE, you must understand, they must play a mediation role and play a role that is, we should make sure there's a platform that we open up and make sure everyone comes in and talk about this issue. And we'll be able to understand and identify to say who are the zamas, who are the other people who are not really genuine in this case. And most of all, we find that is most of the people who are creating the situation is the syndicate on top who are benefiting from the zamas. And based on that, if we engage the zamas, we'll be able to find out who are the syndicate, who are really creating the situation. Because those are the people who are collecting people from Lesotho to come and work them for them for cheap labor. And now they even arm them to do that. But the issue of zamas, if you can find out from 2014, and now it's only now it's out of hand. Communities were not really complaining about zamas because some of the zamas were living in the community and knew what is happening. In 2016, when we marched to DMRE, there was no issue of out of hand zamas because it was a genuine trying to make sure that is we formalize, decriminalize, and make sure that the sector is reformed to be a contributing factor in reducing the number of unemployed.
Thank you very much for your time this afternoon. Meshack Mbangela from the Mining Affected Communities United in Action, or Makua for short.